Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How you guys doing? Praise God. Welcome tonight. Good to see everyone. Thanks. Welcome, YouTubers. Just want to make a couple of announcements. We have books, the bookstore open. If you guys want to check out some books, Brother Mike's selling in there, and some other books that he recommends on deliverance and healing. Check it out. Talk to Lori. I don't know the prices. I should bring that out here. I keep forgetting about that stuff, and I'm so sorry about that. But go and talk to Lori. Okay? Welcome, YouTubers. Welcome tonight. Anyone new here? Anyone new? Hi. Good to see you. Are you from out of state? From here? Oh, good. Well, good to have you. What part of this state are you from? Are you from the Chandler, Mesa, Gilbert? You're from Glendale. Okay, nice. Long drive, but that's all right, right? You made it. Thank you, Lord. And then Brother Mike has a seminar August 30th. Tell your friends. It's going to be good. It's always good. All right. So any testimonies, any healing testimonies? Anybody want to give a healing testimony? Anybody have one tonight? You have one, brother? All right. Come on up. Is that okay?
Oh, yeah.
God bless you, brothers and sisters, to the YouTube watchers. First and foremost, I want to thank God. The healing is ongoing. Deliverance is ongoing, as it's also as taught by the brothers and sisters here at ADC. A year ago, about this time, this month, I was in a very, 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 very bad and dark moment. Never in my life have I encountered panic attacks or anxiety attacks, especially suicide. But I lost a lot of things. I left a lot of things. I left my career behind, my finances, my home back in California, and I lost it all. So I hit bottom. And I had no understanding of mental health, but I especially didn't understand what spiritual warfare was and what the attacks that I was enduring morning, day, and night. And I could not go back to work. I had fear going back to work because those attacks first happened at work. And with so much fear, there was so much doubt. With so much doubt, I had no balance. And I thought I was going to lose it. I thought my life was over and done. My mind could not reason. I had no speech. I had no good memory. I had no function. My brain was so bad that I went to doctors, you know, prescription. I went to church, and no one could really help me what was going on, or at least introduce to me what really was going on to my life until I came to ADC about a year ago. So the healing went ongoing, and I've seen a lot of chains being breaking off of my life, and I thank God for that. And spiritual warfare is so important in everyone's life, man, woman, and child. And I'm still ongoing, but why I'm here giving a testimony is because it's been 1 year since I haven't gone back to work. And this is my first week that I've been back to work. And I'm not going to boast myself with pride or ego, but it is a beautiful thing that I can go back to work. And I am thankful because it's a blessing to go back to work. It's a privilege to work. And that I thank God for that, because I never valued what I had in my life and what I was able to do with hands and with the brain. So I tell you all, healing did not happen in 24 hours. But healing is how fast you allow the Lord in your life to heal you and also allow to learn and understand spiritual warfare. Because once you're in, you're going to see some things, experience some things, but you're going to see victory in Christ's name. Amen.
Come on, sir. Come on, give it up for Jesus. Hallelujah. Come back to work. Thank you, Lord. All right, Brother Mike.
All right. Welcome to the Deliverance Center. Bible study time. Ready to rumble. Okay, radio shows are on every day of the week. We're on one time Saturday and two times on Sunday there on 10 a.m. And we're always on 24/7 on the website. You can go to that one, Omni FM, and then catch any radio program you want. Archives as well. 48,000 people last week on darkskyradio.com. I'm on every night of the week there. at 9 o'clock. The most listened city is what? Dallas, Texas. Yes, sir. I'm very popular in Dallas, Texas. The most listeners in what country is? India. Yeah, there you go. India, Dallas, Texas. That's right. Phoenix, Arizona. Wow. Truth is stranger than fiction. Hey, would you like to help our ministry out? I didn't get any amens, but once in a while somebody does. And if you go to smileamazon.com and put in our charity name and buy something, they'll give us 1.2% of what you spent on your trip to Smile Amazon. Thank you. Today's teaching will be on our number one YouTube page, House of Healing AZ. Please send me an email. You can pick up the self-deliverance lists. I send out, gosh, dozens of those a week. I wrote 3 books. They're in the bookstore, one on healing, one on being cured from mental illnesses, and one on the devil. Thursday nights, our healing room and our class with Rick is at 7 p.m. Thing is booming. And we also have a mental illness healing class on Thursday nights at 7 p.m. Okay? Open for Christians with mental illnesses. If you're not saved and you've got a mental illness, you're welcome to come to the class, but you got to get born again first. You have to get born again first. Because we won't be able to help you. We can't help you. You got to get born again first to get healed and cured of a mental illness. Here. That we don't have anything for it. I did the secular thing for 25 years. I'm not going to go back there. I never cured anybody. Okay, got to get saved first. And that's better than anything anyway. Hey, the donation boxes are on the door. 5 minutes, those doors will be locked. Kelly flips the Arnie switch in the booth there, and the system shuts down. You can donate on the website. My Omega Man radio programs, man, they're going fantastic. It's unbelievable. I just can't believe how many people listen to me on that program. Okay, I'll be on there in a couple weeks again. Those things go fantastic. Very grateful for them. Hey, the great prophet Joseph. Well, he's a great guy to look at, isn't he? I'm going to look at him a little different than you've ever heard before. Here in America, we don't have the class system here. For example, in India. But we do kind of have one. You know, if you're born into a certain family, the probability that things are going to go pretty good for you, if it's a rich family, the odds are stacked in your favor. If you're born into a rotten family, the probability is things aren't going to go very well for you. It's not absolute. Yeah? But if you're in Hollywood, and you're a son or daughter of a movie star and you're rich and all this other stuff, you kind of grow up in that environment. And how you grow up, as you know, is what kind of a person you turn into. Your formative years are the most important years. And, if you're in a privileged family, like in Hollywood or some rich people, kids grow up kind of spoiled. And they just they're used to having everything. They're used to having notoriety. They're used to being in public. They're used to being in the tabloids. They're used to being recognized. Oh, that's so-and-so's daughter. That's so-and-so's son. Well, guess what? Joseph had the same thing. He grew up in a Hollywood-type family. His father was the head guy in all of Israel. He was a breeding machine. He had 12 sons. Oh, that's a lot of kids. He had, I don't know how many daughters. He had sons and daughters. He had a whole covey of children. He was famous. Everybody in the whole country knew who he was. And Joseph grew up in that family. He grew up in a wealthy home, a privileged home. Wealthy people get stuff other kids don't get. Duh. The best of everything, the clothes, the shoes, even their underwear. I like this underwear here. Walmart. And I wasn't raised in a Hollywood home, a millionaire's home. See? If I was, I wouldn't be wearing these underwear. I would maybe have some velvet. But Joseph was raised in a velvet underwear family. Yes, sir. He had everything. Everything. I was raised in a white trash neighborhood, white trash parents, drunks. I was an idiot. We were all together. We didn't know we were dumb. See, when you're being raised, you don't know nothing. Joseph was raised, are you getting this? Privileged. He was privileged. Okay? Genesis chapter 37. You all know the story. I'll go through it quickly. Israel, of course, that was Jacob. He loved Joseph more than all of his children. He was the son of his old age. Joseph was, boom, yeah. Joseph had it, yeah. He was virile as an old man, yeah. I fizzled out years ago. Not Joseph, no. He had wives, he had concubines. One would go out, bring another in. No problem. But he had all these kids, a whole covey of them, but one of them struck his fancy. He loved one of them more than all the others. And he made a tragic mistake that many parents do. And it scars the family and it scars the child. When a parent picks out one child over the others and shows that favoritism to the other family members. It crushes the other family members and it breeds sin. It breeds jealousy, bitterness, anger. Kids don't like that. God runs his family totally differently. Every single child in the family, 2 billion, 2 million, whatever the number is, all of them are loved exactly the same. And the benefits of the glorious gospel of Christ are given out to every single child based on the same criteria. Your faith. You could have anything Wigglesworth had, preacher, and you'll probably will, knowing him. You could have anything any other God's child got. Because you are loved exactly the same. And God is no respecter of persons. But Joseph's family wasn't like that. Jacob, a great man of God, was a parental screw-up. He favored his youngest boy above the other daughters and sons in the family. And that caused a lot of trouble. In fact, he went so far in his foolishness to give him a colored coat. When you give a child, give to that one, and you don't give to that one, it breeds jealousy in the family. And the parent caused it because they're ignorant. Jacob, the great man of God, was ignorant when he gave that coat to Joseph. He should have never done it. No, he should have never done it. Hell followed after that coat. When you pick one kid out over another and you're a parent, you better get ready for the fires of hell. They'll come right through your front door. The kid that got the coat starts to expect everything. Oh, they start to feel a little privileged. The ones that didn't get the coat start to develop qualities of Satan, envy, bitterness, jealousy. Those are soul damning sins. Who caused it? Joseph? No. He was innocent. He loved his dad. He loved his brothers. He loved his family. Everything was handed to him on a silver platter. And he got him a nice new coat the other ones didn't get. To make it worse, it is all covered. Oh, stupid. He could at least give him a dark black smock to wear so he could kind of hide in the darkness. No, not Jacob. Not old Jacob. Uh-uh. Rocks in the head. Let's give him a colored one. Let's color him up. Okay? Let's turn him into the clown of the family. Joseph, the great man of God, started out privileged, pampered, extra love, extra gifts, extra benefits. When you do that to a kid and you don't do it to the others, oh, you as a parent pay a worse price than the kids pay later. There he is, an actual picture. I found it on Google. He had that colored coat. I don't know how they got that thing. Google's amazing. When his brethren saw their father loved Joseph more than them, they what? Hated him. It wasn't Joseph's fault. It doesn't matter. Jealousy, bitterness, envy, and hate don't require justice. They exist on their own. Joseph was innocent. He loved his dad. He disliked colored coats. He told his mom that, I wish I had a colored coat. Jacob heard it. Said, honey, weave him a colored coat. Go out and get the bugs and the plants and whatever we dye this stuff with. And they fixed him up one. Man, he looked sharp. He was a well-dressed man. He looking good. But his brothers hated him. And it was his dad's fault. In fact, they hated him so much, they didn't want to talk to him. The bitterness was so heavy, they couldn't even have a decent word with him. What time is it, guys? What do you care? Can I have a sandwich? Go eat outside! Wow. Would you help me with? No! Could I go with you? No! The bitterness makes no sense. Hate has no IQ. Wow. They hated him. His dad, in a way, curse the poor kid. One night Joseph had a dream. Uh-oh, this thing's going to get worse. And they hated him even more. He said, listen, I had a dream. Wearing his colored coat. Hey, I had a dream. Look at these colors. Yeah, you look like somebody dug you up, but look at me. Daddy gave me a colored coat. He was spoiled. He was privileged. He ran his mouth like a busted chainsaw. Look at me. Oh, look at my new car. Look at my clothes. Look at me. See? And every time he said, look at me, hatred. Hatred and envy and bitterness went right through every one of the boys. Hey, I dreamed a dream. And we were out in the field and the sheaves were there, and I was this sheave, and then you guys were these other sheaves, and guess what you guys did? You came and bowed down to me in the field. How do you like that? Oh, how'd they like that? We'll find out in a minute. His brethren said, you're going to reign over us? Are you nuts? And they hated him more. Every time a privileged child gets something given to them that they haven't earned in front of the other kids, bitterness and envy and hate begins to breed in the family. And it gets worse. It's like turning the heat up. Now they really hate his guts because he's claiming God's talking to him. He's not only got a colored coat, which we ain't got. God's talking to him. He don't talk to us. We're going to get rid of this kid. He's not a brother anymore. We hate his guts. We got enough brothers. Oh, if that wasn't enough, Albert Einstein Joseph has another dream. Good job, buddy. Keep going. I don't see this ending too well. I dreamed another dream, and look, the sun was there, and the moon was there. Oh, there's the stars. And guess what happened? All the sun and the moon and the stars came down and bowed in front of me. I like that dream. You can hear every one of the brothers growling. You can see the irritable bowel syndrome. You can sense the rage. Hey, once you favor one child over another, I'm talking to parents now, you favor one child over the other, you're cursing that child. They don't have to work anymore. No, because I'm the pride of the family. My dad likes me best. I don't have to prove myself like the others. I don't have to work like the others. I got a red carpet in front of me. You pamper a child, you give them too much, you don't make them work, you don't make them stand up. Guess what that does? They just fall off into the gates of hell when they get older. The parents are sitting there weeping their eyes out, saying, why did this happen to me? Well, I don't know. I have no idea. Let's check it out. You pampered them. You let them off. You didn't discipline them. You gave them too much, and you've done it in front of the other kids. Oh, nothing going wrong there. No, your child's going to grow up just fine. Brother Mike's going nuts tonight. No, you don't know. I'm sitting at my desk and I'm counseling families who are doing exactly what I'm saying. You think I'm making this up? I'm just simply sharing what I face. Yes. Right. Yes. Son of the moon, that's now he's gone overboard, man. He's losing it now. The sun, that's Jacob. The great patriarch, the great man of God's going to bow in front of this kid? You got to be kidding. Furious. They're furious at this kid. But they can't take him out now because dad's watching. See, dad's got that covering of privilege over him. Dad gave him too much. Dad loved him too much. He's got a colored coat on. See, when you got colors on, nobody touches you. He said, come. One day they're all out in the field. They're checking on the flocks. All the brothers are working. And Jacob goes, man, we haven't heard from them in a long time. Hey, colored coat boy, come here. Why don't you go find your brothers and bring me back word that they're okay because I'm worried about them. You know, it wasn't he didn't love the other brothers. Of course he loved them. That wasn't his mistake, loving the brothers. It's a sin not to love your children. You love every single one of them. It's a sin to benefit the one over the others. That is also a sin. Hello?
Okay.
This thing even on tonight? Why don't you go see him? Well, they saw him coming. Yonder. They saw, there's Joseph, colored boy, color coat. There he is. Bright pink, blue, red. Here he comes. Let's have it. Let's greet him when he gets here. Let's murder him and throw him into a well, pit, war in Hebrew. Throw him into this well. We'll kill him. And then what we'll do, we'll take that colored coat off of him, and everybody hates that coat. The coat is the symbol of injustice.
Wow.
You didn't hear me. When you bought the car for this one, you didn't buy the car for that one. You bought that for this one, you didn't do it for the other. That material thing becomes a symbol of injustice.
Okay.
They hated that coat as much as they hated him.
Right.
And we'll just kill him and dump him as well. No problem. Then we'll see what happens to his dreams. The dreamer, Mr. Dreamer. Reuben steps up. Who the heck is Reuben? Oh, man. He's the firstborn screw up. Every dysfunctional family has a firstborn screw up. Think about it right now. I'll give you 60 seconds. Think about a bunch of families who the firstborn is, who's a complete loon. God, just thought of my own family. Oops, I'm firstborn. My God, Reuben steps up, the firstborn in the family, but he's already screwed up. And Jacob's already dumped him. You remember the story. He, one night, lost his control. Lust took over, and he slept with lust. Demons are superpower. They'll lead you into nothing but trouble and horror.
Right, right, right.
He slept with one of Jacob's concubines. His status in the family clanked. Reuben. So Reuben, living under this cloud of failure, he's a failure in the family. Some people who fail in the family, one of them gives up and leaves. The other one tries to make up and stay. Reuben was a make up and a stayer. He wanted to fix it, so he says, hey, wait a minute. Let's just throw him into this well. And he's thinking in his mind, I'll come back and get him later. Then I'll take Joseph home, and I'll be Superman. I'll be the hero. And therefore, my dad, who thinks I stink now because I screwed up, will take me back and put me back in that privilege as the firstborn in the family. I'll pull this thing out of my hat. Whoa! Vegas. See, Reuben's thinking he's trying to get his status back as a non-loser. Jacob actually mentioned his opinion of him in Genesis chapter 49, if you want to read it, but it was not good. Not good, okay? I've been a counselor for many years, as you know. Let me give you a little tip. A lot of times I do community service, public service type stuff. Do not have sex with one of your parents' spouses. There you go. Just thought I'd throw that out to you. There you go. You get an opportunity to sleep with your stepmom or something. Whoa! Pass on it. Pass on it. You're welcome. Hey, they look up down the trail there, as usual, and they see a caravan coming, right, of Midianites. They're heading to Egypt to sell their stuff. Business as usual. So they decide, hey, this is great. We'll take Goofy out of the well. We'll sell him to the Midianites. We'll cut a lamb or a sheep. We'll spill the blood over it. And that way we can go back to Pops and tell him and that wild animal got him. We win. We get rid of the colored coat. We get rid of Joseph. Both things they hated. We are not at fault for anything. And it's not our fault. And we'll simply comfort our father after he's done mourning. And problem solved. Problem solved. Listen, let me give you another little tip here. Whenever you sit around listening to demons on solving problems, guess what? Things don't go very good.
Right.
No. Sitting around listening to demons trying to fix your family without following the word of God, guess what? Divorce, collapse, your family's going down the tubes.
Yes, sir.
Listening to demons, not a good idea.
Right.
So they sold him 20 pieces of silver. That was a lot of money. All his sons and daughters rose up to comfort. Who? Jacob. They went back and put their plot there. We don't know. We don't know what happened to him. We ran off. He was laying there when we came home. What'd you do? Send him out to get us? Yeah, I sent him out. Didn't you guys hear from you? I was worried about you. Well, Father, I'm so sorry. Joseph's dead. He's dead. Wolves must have got him. Lion or something. Here, look. Here's a colored coat, Dad. Here's your coat, Dad. Well, Jacob was crushed. He was destroyed. Because that was his favorite thing in life. In the same way that Isaac was a favorite thing in Abraham's life. Same thing here. These kind of behaviors go right down your family tree. Good behaviors and bad, they go right down the family tree. Let me tell you something. You've been living in sin in front of your kids? your kids will become just like you, and they will sin more than you. The next generation watches their parents, okay? And they just sit there and watch it like they're watching a ball game. From the time they're 2 to the time they're 15, they sit right there, front row seat, watching mom and dad. What are they doing today? Screaming at each other. Oh, that's how you do it. Oh, folks, somebody got slapped. Okay, that's another option. Oh, cussing them up. UMF, USO. Oh, that's another option. Give them a good cussing. Gotcha. And the kids absorb it instantly. Children are like sponges. And then when you get older, there's nothing but tears in your eyes because your children now are just like you. Listen, I've been a counselor for years. I'm just sharing what I see every day. I'm not making this stuff up. I see it with my own eyes. I know stuff, not because I think I know it. Oh, he gets to Egypt, and guess what happens? God loved Joseph. And when he saw the plot the devil had for him to kill him and throw him down a well, the Holy Ghost moved in behind. The devil never saw it coming. He never does. Nobody's ever seen the Holy Ghost. Not in heaven or not in earth. You know what? And that's why the devil's afraid of him. He never sees him coming. You can't beat somebody you can't see coming. It's just like immediately, suddenly, boom, the Holy Ghost on top of him. It says he'll flee. Why do you think he's fleeing? Because of you? Oh, far from it. The Spirit of God snuck up on him. He didn't know it again. The Holy Ghost had this whole thing. He said, hey, you're going to do that? Okay, I'm going to make that move. See, it's a spiritual chess match in the kingdom of heaven. He says, Joseph has a gift. Joseph has a gift. I gave him that gift. And I'm going to use it. Let me tell you something. Listen to me carefully. Somebody throw you down a well? I'll tell you what. The Holy Ghost went down the well with you. You throw down a well, everybody turned their back on you? Everybody in your family thinks you suck? Really? Somebody doesn't think you suck. Amen. Somebody's watching behind, in the scenes, in the shadows. No one sees him. Hallelujah. Watching for you. Joseph had no idea who in God's name was going to save him at the bottom of a well. You can't climb out. There's no water down there. He's going to die.
Come on, sir.
No, friend. You had some tough times? Hey, it's going to turn around real soon.
Hallelujah.
They sold him. Who did they sell him to? A bunch of homeless people? No. The Holy Ghost stepped in and said, hey, you buy him. You buy him. Uh-oh. Potiphar got him. Who's Potiphar? Some homeless guy? No, far from it. Far from it. He was rich. He had a major position in Egypt. He was a big shot, to say the least. And he started watching Joseph. Okay? Listen, friends. Joseph had to start out as a slave Egyptian trainee. And the Holy Ghost requires you, if you want to serve him, to start out as a servant trainee. Yeah. Nobody starts out at the top. Nobody starts out. Joseph started out as a trainee. And somebody's watching you. You think they're not watching you. You think you got away with it. Oh, in the spirit world, you're being tailed. Joseph was being watched by Potiphar. Potiphar's going, hey, wait a minute here. Holy smoke. This kid's got the anointing of Yahweh, the eternal God of the Hebrews, is on him. He was watching him and saw God blessing him. He wasn't like a slave trainee. He had something different about him. Listen, friend. Listen. You went through some hard times and you got discouraged. That dampened your anointing. If you'll repent tonight, bang, it'll come instantly back to you.
Yes.
And somebody will notice you.
Yes.
And this time in a good way, not in a bad way like you're used to. He found grace in his sight. So what happened? A, he had the fruit of the Spirit back then. Before there was a Pentecost, right, Eric? He had the fruit of the Spirit back then. He had a little, I'm going to say the word. I'm going to say it in front of Christians. Oh, my God. Integrity. Oh, Jesus. He had integrity. Yeah. You can't find that in a church anymore, but back in the 3,000 years ago, some kid in a well had some integrity.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Holy smoke. Jesus. I think I'll just preach it. He says, hey, this guy does everything right. He seems to have some blessing on his life. My God, he's got some integrity. I can trust him with this. I can trust him with that. I'm going to promote him up from a slave trainee. See, you don't get it. You want everything from God now, yesterday, and the day before. You're not going to get it. You know why? You got to start out as a trainee. In America, people want to start out at the top. Got any management jobs? Jesus. God in heaven. What's your experience? I just graduated from college. I got my associate degree. Oh, you want a management job? See, Joseph, under the anointing, agreed to start at the bottom. He was happy with it. Because starting as a slave trainee was a major step up from being at the bottom of a well. Potiphar goes, you know something? I got other things to do. You can have everything in this house. You take the whole business except my trophy wife. Yeah, rich men love trophy wives. Yeah, they dump their old wife. She's a bag. She ain't looking like a bag. She sings and drooping. Yeah, bones are moving. But when you have money, you get you a trophy wife. That's what old Potiphar did. He got him some hot babe. Oh, she was built. Oh, she had it. Yeah. She couldn't stand the guy, but he loved having her. Yeah. No woman likes some ugly old man touching them. They're lying. That's a public service thing. They're lying. They're lying. So the father come in, pass gas. Hi, honey. Hi. Oh, sweetheart, you looking hot. Oh, my God, how long do I have to do this? He got him a trophy wife. She didn't like him, but that luxury lifestyle means a lot more than just some sex here and there. See, women will sacrifice their bodies for a luxury lifestyle or to get some bills paid. It happens all the time. It's just a routine thing. Don't tell me it isn't. You get everything in this house except my wife. Well, Joseph didn't care because he had integrity and he didn't want the wife. A Christian who doesn't want to commit adultery, unbelievable. Wow. How did that happen? Gave him everything right there. And here's the killer. Joseph has a couple things that I don't have. I don't like him either. It says here, Joseph was a goodly and well-favored. Toar in Hebrew means he had a great-looking body. Yeah. In GQ. Mare means drop-dead gorgeous. Yeah. See, I don't like him either. There's Joseph. There he is. God gave him dreams. Dad gave him a pretty coat to wear. Oh, and he looked better than everybody else. No wonder they hated him. And it came to pass that, hey, Joseph hanging around the house here for a while. And Potiphar's wife, getting kind of tired of that Potiphar guy. He looks like somebody dug him up. She wants a hot babe, a GQ guy. And guess what? He right there in the house.
Right.
She thought she hit the lottery. Las Vegas. Yeah. Wow. Oh my God. Trophy wife with a boy toy at home. Oh my God. She was praying to every idol she could make. Thank you, Bill. Thank you. Might as well do it today. Come lively. Joseph said, are you kidding me? Your master gave me everything he has. He put complete, total trust in me.
Amen.
He trusted me with everything. I'm going to trash him by sleeping with you? She couldn't believe it. The first person in Egypt that had integrity. She hadn't met anybody. She was stunned. You're kidding. Christian integrity are very rare. Back then it was non-existent. How could I sin against God like this by sleeping with you? What are you? Gotta be kidding. Well, it goes on. You know the story. You've all read it. It came to pass. Day by day, she came after him. See, you don't understand. The devil doesn't come to you with a little temptation and then walk away discouraged. Oh, gee, that's, you know, he didn't read that. He didn't say that. He didn't do that. He hurt my feelings. Are you crazy? You must be nuts. The demons come right back, different angle, another different angle. They move another different way. They keep pressing in until you give in. Day by day, she came after him. And she was getting desperate. He made a mistake one day. He goes into the house. Nobody's home. Now the devil's got him. It was a setup. The demon set it up. Just like he set your life up. Remember that? Remember when you got married? Remember that one? Remember the gun almost went there? You pushed it back? Yeah, those wives and husbands were plants. They were plants to destroy you. And you crushed. You were crushed. He set it up. The devil moved everybody out of the house. He came home. There's nobody there. Perfect setup for a liaison. Hello. Some of you are looking at me like, you can't believe this. Can't believe it either. And he wouldn't do it. So the devil told the trophy wife, listen, just grab him and drag him in there, girl. When are you going to see this again? Oh, she was drooling over him. Does anybody ever know what a basset hound is? Anybody ever heard of a basset hound? Well, they're a kind of dog, a hound dog, and what about 30 something years ago, I made the mistake of getting one. And they're friendly, loving dogs. That stuff's great. But never eat around a basset hound. Because while you're eating, if you look down, there's a pool of drool on your carpet. And as soon as that dog, they have a tremendous sense of smell. Okay, they can smell a ham sandwich 6 blocks away. The dog starts instantly to drool.
Wow.
You ever heard of that dog, basset hound?
Yes.
This basset hounds are like Potiphar's wife. Every time she looked at Joseph, and look at that body, oh, he was built. Look at that face. No, if he didn't look like me, sir, he didn't look like you either. No offense. This is gorgeous. And she's pulling the basset out. Pool of drool. Pool of drool. Lust! Eating her apart. Come on. Lust killing her. She dove at him. And I'll tell you what, listen, that's funny, but it ain't funny when the devil dives at you. Particularly when he's got an opening. You're going to get sick. Your family's going to crash. Your finances are going to dump. If he gets an opening, he will move in and take. He will dive at you. Joseph said, "Hey, you're not going to get me." He leaped out of that jacket, fell off. He's running out the door saying, "Oh my God, that's the second jacket I've lost now. That's the second jacket. I can't keep any jackets." Potiphar staggers home. "Hi, honey. Who's home? Gorgeous. Oh, gee. Oh, God. Gag me with a spoon." She goes, "Look." She's laying in bed when he comes in. "Look. Oh, God, I'm so distressed. I'm more. Oh, it's unbelievable. Look, there's the coat. He tried to rape me." "Yeah, you're the guy you trusted and gave him everything? Tried to take your loving, sweet wife." At that moment, Potiphar should have grabbed a bottle of Jim Beam and just headed for the yard. But he didn't. He believed her. You wouldn't believe how many people will take a lie from the devil, a bold-faced lie. Just believe it. Happens all the time. He turned on him. You know what he did? Yeah, he was the head of the guards. The guards come in, found the guy, took him. Now Joseph is back in the well. He's in prison now. But guess what? Listen to me carefully. I know things are tough for you right now. And I know that you're frustrated, maybe angry, maybe just exhausted. I understand that, and that happens to all of us. But if you will keep doing the right thing, if you will just have a little patience with the Holy Ghost, he's standing right there. He saw you getting thrown in a well. He saw you go into the dungeon. He's watching you. He knows what's happening to you. He hasn't left you. If you'll just hang on a little bit longer, he'll work it out behind the scenes for your good. Same thing happens again. God blesses him, and instead of Potiphar seeing the anointing on him, see, if you'll do the right thing and stop sinning and turn your life over to the Lord, you will get your anointing and other people will see it. Amen. Other people will see your giftings.
Yes.
You keep living like a carnal, lukewarm Christian, half in Christianity, half in the world, you're not going to get an anointing back, and everybody's going to see you as a hypocrite.
Right.
"Oh, Brother Mike, you don't preach like they do at Hillsong." Yeah, but you're not at Hillsong.
That's right.
We don't do Hillsong. Well, where's the band? It's at Hillsong. Go over there. He got favor. See? You can have everybody turn on you. If the Holy Ghost with you, you'll end up with favor.
Hallelujah.
Relatives, oh, they want to murder you. Friends, they abandon you. Employer, he dumped him. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. You are not alone.
Thank you, Jesus.
The keeper of prisons did the same thing Potiphar said. "Hey, this guy's special. This is nuts. He shouldn't be in prison. He's got integrity. He must be one of these people that go to prison when they weren't guilty. And I can trust this guy. Everything I see him do, everything I see him say, hey, I feel comfortable with this guy. I'm going to turn the prison over to him. We'll take him out of the dungeon, make him a prison manager." Yeah. Being a prison manager. What a dream. Joseph comes in. He's talking to two guys from the Pharaoh's court. What the heck are they doing here? He's curious. Most of the people there in the jail are scum. Criminals, liars, cheaters, murderers, rapists, all this human pond scum. Hey, what are these two guys doing here? He sees that and he picks it up. He comes in to investigate. He said, "What's up? Why you look so sad today?" He said, "Well, we had dreams last night. We had dreams, and we don't have anybody here to interpret these dreams for us." Listen, you've gone through some bad times. You've gone through some hard times. You've gone through the gates of hell. If you'll just be patient a little longer,
amen,
somebody's going to notice you. The Holy Ghost told him to notice you. He said, "Hey, look over there. There she is. There he is." And suddenly, you'll get a break. You never expect it. These two guys from Pharaoh's court end up in prison. Very rare. And along comes Joseph. Oh, don't you see? The Holy Ghost, he works behind the scenes. He can control things in your benefit. You can't even conceive or believe. He's unstoppable. He said, "Well, you need some interpretive dream, do you?" You saw the story. The butler had a dream about vines, remember? The baker had a dream about three baskets, remember that? The candlestick maker, he'd already been released, so he wasn't there, he didn't have a dream. And then, on the third day, that Joseph predicted, Pharaoh's birthday. And he's sitting there thinking, "Man, my best butler is in prison. You know, maybe I was too hasty. And my baker's down there, but I've replaced him. This other baker's a lot better than that one. I don't need him anymore. Candlestick maker, he ain't around anymore." And guess what happened? They got out just like Joseph said. He restored them to their jobs. He hung the other guy. And the butler, who had promised, see, you were promised by somebody. "Oh, I'll help you. I'll show up. I'll loan you the money. I'll be there. I'll help you move." You ever called a Christian to help move? You might as well be calling Ethiopia. But they're not around. They're not here. They took a plane somewhere. And guess what? This happens all the time to born-again Christians. Somebody who said they would help them, who said they would be there, they said, "I'll pray for you, I'll help you, I'll loan you the money." They forgot you. Routine. See, the butler forgot Joseph, but because he kept his integrity, somebody else remembered him. You don't need people to remember you when the Holy Ghost has you in mind.
Amen.
What do you got to do to keep this going? You've got to be patient. It's a four-letter word to Christians, but patience. You possess your soul in your patience. Patience is the most valuable thing in the world if you're in the spirit world. Patience is the key. Joseph had it. He wasn't the idiot running around his house showing off his coat, telling his brothers about it. No, Joseph had matured quickly. And let me tell you something. When you're thrown in a well, when you're thrown in a dungeon, you mature fast that way. Yeah. As soon as you get away from your enablers, you will become a changed person. Years go by and somebody else has a dream. You remember it? Seven heifers. Para is a heifer. 7 ears of corn. Had two dreams. Remember? I didn't go through all this because I know you've already read these stories several times. So I was just hoping to, you know, get through a little quicker. That's okay. Should I have gone? No? Okay. Pharaoh's all shook up about it. He doesn't know what these dreams are. So he makes the mistake of checking with the devil first. Typical born-again Christian. They'll ask everybody in the world about a fix for this or that and that and that, except God. Happens all the time. I know. Happens all the time. Oh, he calls in all these demon-possessed guys. Fortune tellers, soothsayers, seers. Seers, see. Nowadays, the Christians go to a prophetic service. Can you give me a word? Can you give me a word? Can you give me one? Can you get... Yeah, I'll give you a whole pack of them. Here's God's holy word. Take that home and read. Yeah. Oh, I don't want to read that. I'm too lazy. I just need somebody to give me a word. Jeez, you got to be kidding. No wonder that prophetic movement has infected demons. You got to be kidding. People are nuts. Oh, these guys couldn't do it. But then suddenly a thought pops in the butler's mind. The Holy Ghost is able to put a thought in somebody's mind on your behalf.
Amen.
He's able to do it. I've heard countless testimonies. Brother Mike, you're not going to believe it. I was sitting at home. We were broke. I lost this, that, and then suddenly this guy called me. Then I answered the phone. He said, can you meet me tomorrow? And then he had a friend, and they tell me this chain, weird supernatural chain of events that got them where they needed to go. That's the Spirit of God. That's routine for him. He just does it. But even think about it. Boom, 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 puts it out. No problem. The butler, click, God, point. Hey, you remember that guy in prison, the interpreting dreams, that Hebrew guy? Remember that good-looking guy? Oh, he remembered. Yeah, I remember that guy. What's he do? He tells Pharaoh about it. Hey, we had these dreams, and this exactly what he said came true, unlike these YouTube prophets. Oh, my God. If you see YouTube and prophet in the same sentence, go ahead and drink the Kool-Aid. Now, these YouTube prophets, 99% of them are absolute farces. Do not listen to these kooky people on YouTube. Okay? Only a few people on YouTube have any credibility.
Wow.
Back to the scripture here. He said, hey, you ought to see this guy. He's a killer. So Pharaoh says, go get him. See? But it wasn't Pharaoh telling him. It's the Spirit of the Lord moving on your behalf. Why? Because you left your life of sin. You stopped getting impatient. You stopped taking offenses. You started to trust. And then he moves. When he moves, no one can stop him. Joseph had every reason to give up on God. Every single reason in the book. His family rejected him. His employer rejected him. His trophy wife lied about him. She made the whole story up. It was utterly fabricated. Every bit of it. He got thrown in the dungeon. That was the bottom section of the prison, the dungeon. That's where they threw the murderers, the rapists, the killers, the psychos. He had every reason to give up on God. Every reason. But he had what you have. A choice. Joseph and you have the same thing. You're both the same. You have a choice to make tonight.
Amen.
I heard about you. If you'll keep your integrity and stop taking offenses, stop griping, stop bitching, stop moaning, stop having a fit, stop blaming everybody else for your problems. If you'll stop that and repent of it, the Holy Ghost will move on your behalf. And nobody will stop him. Nobody can stop him. And somebody will hear about you out of the blue. It's like a miracle. Oh. Excuse me, it is a miracle. I heard about you. See, if you keep your integrity and you keep your spiritual honesty and decency, somebody's going to hear about you when you need it the most. I understand you can interpret dreams and so on. I understand you're a big shot. Pharaoh was puffing him up like one of the kings in another country. Oh, Joseph never fell for that. He said, I can't do anything. I'll check with Jehovah. Unlike Samson, his gifts didn't go to his head. And he didn't want to end up with his eyes poked out. Public service announcement, get a chance. Don't let your eyes get poked out. Not good. But when you start thinking it's your ability and your capacity and, oh, you're gifted and, oh, you got an anointing. I know you're so good. That's when the devil will dump you right down a well. And God won't save you from it because you demanded it. It's not me, it's God. You remember the dream, right? 7 years of plenty. Booming. 7 years of a nightmare. The nightmare will be worse than the boom times. That's what Joseph told him. What happened then? God's incredible destiny for Joseph's life came to him. Why? Why? He needed to be thrown in a well. He needed to be in a dungeon. Why? His dad screwed him over, preach. He was raised spoiled. He expected stuff. It was all handed to him. He didn't have to work for anything. He just got it. Well, the Holy Spirit saw what the devil was doing and said, I'm just going to use that attack of the devil to further out something good for you. I'm going to put my boy, I'm going to let him go down that well. I'm not going to do it. They're going to do it. But I'm going to use that well experience to change his attitude and his character. You see, he needed a dungeon. You took the opposite approach and everything got worse. Why did that, God, what if, is God real? Why is that? How come, geez, God, which is going to get better. See, you went the other way and things got worse. Joseph didn't. He's down in a well. He maintains his faith. He's in a dungeon. My God. Well, what else can go wrong? Potiphar's babe turns on him, makes up a whole story lying like crazy about him. His best friend, Potiphar, fires him. On top of that, he sends him to jail. Jeez, what else could go wrong? Nothing was going wrong. The Holy Ghost sits in the background where the devil can't see him. The devil don't know he's there. And he said, oh, you threw him in a dungeon this time. I'm going to work this out for my boy.
Amen.
Just like he'll work it out for you.
Amen.
For God is no respecter of persons. You, sir, are Joseph. You are. You know why? You've got a choice. You can choose to do what's right in spite of adversity. Am I helping anybody?
Yes.
Pharaoh was blown away by this guy. Wow, that's incredible. Oh my goodness. Here's what you're going to get. Listen, we're a long way from a dungeon now. But he would have never made it there had he been an American Christian. Wait a minute, where's my prosperity? Kenneth Copeland said I got a mansion. Where's that at? I'm on the street. Listen, if you'll maintain your integrity, if you know what integrity is? I better have a teaching on it. If you will maintain your integrity with God and stop taking offenses, stop getting upset, and stop filing complaints, and just use your patience, your God-given patience, the Spirit of the Lord, who is already working behind the scenes on your behalf, He'll lay it out like a buffet table. Yeah. You ever been to Vegas? You ever been to Las Vegas? The whole town is full of demons. I mean, everywhere, except one place, the buffets. Have you ever been to one of them buffets? I mean, you start at this end and you walk two blocks of food down to that end, so like being in hog heaven. What happened? He kept his integrity through the well, through the dungeon, through liars, through rejection. And then the Holy Ghost said, check this out, Joseph. Vegas. Two blocks of food. $27.95. You'll be over my house. Whose house? The most powerful man on the planet Earth.
Hallelujah.
According to your word, Joseph. Okay. Potiphar wouldn't listen to his word. Listen, people are not listening to you now. Take heart. The Spirit of God's working behind the scenes. These people who are not listening to you, these people who are rejecting you, you're going to kiss them goodbye.
Amen.
Now his word is accepted all through Egypt. Only in my throne. And he didn't say it, but he was thinking it. My trophy wives. He had a whole rack of them. Yeah. I like Pharaoh. Pharaoh took off his ring. You know what that meant? That was a sign of huge authority and power. He took his ring, my God. Why? Because Joseph passed his test. He passed the well test. He passed the brother test. He passed the dungeon test. He passed the Potiphar's. And his wife, he passed his test. So God gave him everything. This is a great story.
Amen.
My opinion. He rode in what? Oh my God. This person in the first chariot is the most powerful person on the planet Earth at the time. The person in the second chariot is the second most powerful person on the planet Earth at that time. That guy in the second chariot graduated from dungeon school.
Yeah.
But see, people turn the heat up on you. They're criticizing you. They're running you down. They're putting pressure on you. You collapsed. Oh, you fell over. Ah, you start griping. You complained. It all stopped right there. See, Joseph matured during his trials. Trials are to allow you to mature spiritually. Your trials are your friends.
All right.
If there hadn't have been a dungeon, there would have been no second chariot. Man, unbelievable position of power. Why? Because Joseph didn't take credit for God's miracle working power. Had Joseph taking credit for it, and he could have easily done it, and you could see why he would do it. Everybody else lying about him, everybody else running him down, family, friends, employer, everybody trashing him. My gosh, after a while, you'd like to have a little something for yourself there. Perfectly human nature. Man, gosh, do I have to be a piece of garbage forever? Gosh, I got to get something. Yeah, I'm really good at interpreting dreams. That's me doing it. No, Joseph never fell for that. Oh no. Had he fallen for it, God would have never gave him the interpretation. He would have been back in the dungeon, which is where you're headed if you don't change tonight. Hello. Pharaoh called Joseph's name, Zephana, Pania. He gave him a wife. That's enough. What does this stuff mean? It means he married into the Kennedys. His real family that was supposed to love him dumped him in a well. That happened to you many times. Many of you have had family members and parents who dumped you in a well, so to speak. God, because he kept his integrity and he kept his faith during the tough times, guess what he did? He gave him a new family. Not some family living in the desert. No. No. A rich family. Here's an actual mural of the sun god and the priest ministering to him. Guess what? The dude's only 30 years old. Yep. That I really envy about him. I didn't come to God until I was in my 40s. I blew most of my life. Wouldn't it be great to serve God when you're young and keep going? Wouldn't that be something? Yeah. I envy people. I wish I could have been something like that, but I'm just going to go on with what I got right now.
Amen.
Joseph was 30 years old. My God, no wonder he looked good. He had that GQ body. He had abs. I haven't seen my abs in a couple decades. Yeah, homie, don't play abs anymore. He went all through the land of Egypt, including Potiphar's house. Oh, you don't understand. If you'll change tonight and maintain your integrity toward God during those tough times, God will bring your enemies over to sit at your feet. Potiphar's mouth hit the floor when the chariot pulled up in front of the house.
Right.
Hi, remember me? How's the booty gal doing? How's she doing? Oh, she ran off with a guy in a caravan, huh? What a surprise. Shocking. Let me tell you something, friend. You maintain your integrity with God, the Holy Spirit sees that. He eats that stuff up.
Amen.
And you will be just like Joseph. There he is. I went through a short little life there. He went from a well to what? Ah, ruler of Potter's house. He went from the dungeon to the ruler of the whole prison. 2 years later, he was the ruler of Egypt. My goodness. That was all great, wasn't it? It meant nothing. The key to his life was his destiny. None of that was his destiny. His destiny was Israel. God, hundreds of years ago, made a promise to Abraham and kept it through Joseph. When you pass a little test here, we as human beings, we don't see the big picture. We don't know what's going on here. You don't understand. You may have some massive destiny waiting for you that you didn't see in the dungeon. You didn't see that when your brothers were cursing you. What's the key to all these victories? Maintaining your patience, your integrity. Putting it in perspective. Oh, that's something Christians hate to do. If you put something in perspective, you'll come out a winner.
Yeah.
This situation right now for you, whatever it is, looks horrible. It looks bad. It looks impossible. The Holy Ghost, let me tell you about him, can't even tell you what that word means. He don't know. Impossible? You got him stuttering. You maintain your love and your integrity and your character, and you maintain your patience when things are going bad, the Spirit of God is right on top of you. If you don't see him or feel him, oh, you walk by faith, not by sight. That's got nothing to do with it. He's right there. I guarantee you, when they threw him down that well, he wasn't down there. Hallelujah! No, that didn't happen. He was scared. He was lost. He was alone. He was frightened.
Right.
That's how you are during this short period of time here. There's a trial here. The devil's, he's leaning on you. He's got his foot here. He wants to put it on your neck. No, but you're not going to fall for it. You're not going to start griping and complaining. You're not going to stop pointing fingers. No, you're not. You're going to chill. You're going to do like Moses of the Red Sea. Stand back and see the salvation of God.
Amen. Yes. That's right.
Had there not been a Joseph, there would have never been a Moses. Let's close with what God wants you to do. Okay? The great apostle James hit it right on the head. Couldn't have been any better. Here it is. Be patient, brothers, to the coming of the Lord. Coming of the Lord where? Rapture, second coming, or coming right now to relieve you of this temporary trial you're in. It applies. It applies. Be patient. God's already got you covered. You don't understand, Brother Mike. Everybody's turned on me. I'm in a dungeon. No, you don't understand. I just read the story to you. Now you do understand. Be patient. Just like a farmer, he says. He said, hey, look at farmers. They're patient with crops, right? They wait for this rain. They wait for this rain. They wait for the planting season. They wait for that. They're patient. Look, their patience, James explains, yields a abundant crop. This is what he's saying in so many words. Be patient and stand there. Stand strong. Be patient. Stand there. As soon as the Christians are hit with trials, most of them go, oh my God, they throw their hands up here. Jeez, I can't believe it. They oh, hey, you're not going to believe. No. Drop that. Stand strong. That's what they told the soldiers to do. War, front lines. Boom, they put the shields up. Stand. Be patient. Stand strong. Where? Physically? No. In your spirit, where your the Holy Ghost lives. You, each of you have the Holy Spirit. You have the miracle worker inside you right now. He's right here. Guess what? God's going to pull you out of this thing. Says it right there. I just reworded it, but it's the same thing. If you're patient, God is going to pull you out of this thing. Whatever you're going through. What is it? Money? Job, health, family, kids, crazy kids. Yeah, kids are crazy now. They're nuts. If you stand strong, the Holy Ghost will hunt them kids down.
Amen.
You start having a fit and trying to fix it yourself. Oh, I got to do this for my kids. Now one wants to fix this thing. No. Nothing good's going to happen to them. Listen, man, you got to be patient to have crops, right? I've never been a farmer, but I know somebody told me something about it. Moses took 40 years to get Egypt out of him. 40 years took to get Egypt out of that guy. 400 years for the Jews. My goodness, 400 years. That's a hike. It took 7 trips around to get the Jericho. Listen, had they gone around 6 times and come back to Joshua, hey, Joshua, listen, this... We're out of these horns, okay? Is 6 good enough? Can we?
Right.
6 isn't good enough. Hear the word of the Lord. I said 7.
Yeah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Thus saith the Lord, be patient and establish your hearts.
Amen.
6 wouldn't have done it. Hey, decades. These two prophets waited to see the Moshiach. God had promised them decades ago, you will not die until you see the deliverer with your own eyes. Decades have gone by. If anybody would have quit, they would have. Decades? Come on, man. That's ridiculous. No, it didn't. Notice, Simon, he was there when they brought him in, 8th day. Oh, there he was. God, come here on 8th day. He saw him. Tears in his eyes. Tears in his eyes. You'd be crying too if you waited 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 80, 100. How old was he? I don't know. He's old.
Yeah, right.
He waited decades, and he picked up God's son. Couldn't believe it. You know what he said? Now I can die. Went home and smiled on his face. Took his last breath and went home. Anna come running up. Oh my God, that's him! Waited decades. I got news for your friend. If God promised you something, time is immaterial. That promise will come true if you're patient and establish your hearts. 14 years. Oh my God. This story seems completely fabricated. 14 years a guy waited and worked to get a wife. And that was a beautiful woman. Working 14 years for a woman. That woman. Special. I better get off this. How does God develop patience? Well, you just saw the story of Joseph, didn't you? All right, let's close with the great apostle James. Okay, brothers, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptation, knowing that the testing of your faith. Joseph was young. He saw these dreams. He told his brother about them. Got him in nothing but trouble. He was young. You know anybody that's young? Kind of stupid. They don't make good decisions. I remember when I was young, I thought I was a Rhodes Scholar, but I was really an idiot. Making lots of bad choices. Young people don't have any experience. They don't have any real knowledge. They think they know everything, but they make bad choices. I used to be young. God put him in a well. What was he doing there? He told the great prophet, I'm a potter on the wheel. See that potter in there? Puts his thumbs there, he moves that out. He takes this crap out. He molds that section, then he creases that section. This thing keeps spinning. I'm the potter, Jehovah said. I'm the potter. And since I don't physically come down here and touch you and heal you and sit and talk with you, this is a walk of faith. I use circumstances in your life to use this potter. See that potter put his hands there, thing spins, he's got a bunch of crap in your life. He slops it down. Remember, he does it again. He's moving over here, he pulls that out, and there's a bunch of crappy people that shouldn't be in your life that are causing you spiritual deficits. They're causing you to develop bad spiritual habits. The potter throws that crap out. Yeah, you weren't looking too good, but the potter now making a masterpiece.
Yes.
If you don't have any patience, you'll jump off that wheel and splat down there on your own. Joseph wouldn't have any of it. I can't interpret dreams. God interprets them. He stayed on the wheel. He could have just flopped over, died in that well. I'm not coming up. You guys hurt my feelings. Yeah. You have any idea how many Christians have backslidden over the years over somebody hurting their feelings? You can't even believe it. It's an innumerable number to count. Somebody hurt their feelings. Oh my God. They don't want me. Yeah. You have a Sally Field moment. You like me. You really like me. No, they don't. They just said they did. You got to go through some tests to be molded on the potter's wheel into a magnificent masterpiece, which is what you're going to be someday. Amen. I'm speaking that prophetically. Amen. Let patience have her teleos, complete work. It must be completed. You can't be okay for 6 trips around Jericho and then quit. You got to go the 7. Are you following the word? You got to be telling us complete. You must let it mature you out. Joseph went from a spoiled brat with a colored coat to the leader of Egypt. That's quite a promotion because he didn't lose his integrity and his patience. Had he lost it, we would have never heard of it. Why? So you will lipo, not lack anything. You will be fully equipped, the full armor of God. You will have all 9 fruits of the Spirit and a whole bunch of the gifts of the Spirit. You will be mature and complete. Why? Because you stayed on the wheel. You let the Lord scrape and take a bunch of crap and there you go. There's the porn addiction. There you go, taking offenses. Oh, love of money. Got to have it my way. That Joseph had a huge piece taken off there. Rip. Not have it your way anymore. You're in the dungeon, boy. During trials and tribulations, they're your biggest opportunity and your best friends. This is your chance to learn. That's your chance to grow. How are you going to handle it? Are you going to fail again? I say no. Why? Because you and Joseph have a choice. And the devil cannot take that away from you. The devil couldn't take Joseph's choice away from you. He can't do yours either. You are being called by God, friend, to do his will. Yes. Let's pray. Lord, there's some secret Josephs in this room tonight. There's some secret Josephs. Some people who have enormous spiritual potential are sitting in this room tonight. But their caravan has stalled. It's stalled. Because they lost their patience. This trial was, this challenge, this difficulty lasted a little bit too long. And you lost your patience. You started to act like you did years ago when you were a sinner. You started to handle adversity like you did when you were living in sin. Emotionally, reactively, instead of being patient and steadfast. Some of you are having problems with family members and they drive you crazy. They get on your last nerve constantly. The Spirit of the Lord is telling you, I'll handle that for you. Stand. Steady. Steady. Be patient. Be patient. I'll come through for you. I'll come through for you. the Spirit of God, whom you have right now, he cannot be beaten and he cannot lose. It's impossible. It's impossible. He's waiting for you to choose. Will you do it? Will you choose now? You having a tough time? Yes. All you got to do is reboot it. It's just like the computer. You walk in, beep, you reboot the computer. Boop, tonight, you reboot your faith. You went through this trial and it went badly and you didn't do well. You copped an attitude. You whined. You complained. You griped. And everything got worse. The Holy Ghost never gave up on you. Not even for 1 minute. Through the whole time we went through that trial and you failed, you were cursing and having a fit and blaming other people and screaming and yelling. The whole time you did that, God never gave up on you. Amen. And you can reboot that tonight. Yep. Maybe you are like Joseph in a way. Your family dumped you. Your friends dumped you. Your employer fired you. Somebody else got a promotion. You got cheated. Somebody lied about you. Somebody stabbed you in the back. All those things Joseph went through. My guess is you've gone through them. Your servants here tonight, Lord. They're here. And you can heal them. You can heal them. So they can be like Joseph when he became the prince of Egypt. He never held a grudge against the butler. He never held a grudge against Potiphar. He never held a grudge against Potiphar's wife. He never held a grudge. He let it go. He repented and let it go. You holding a grudge tonight? God's going to forgive you and you're going to repent of it. You're going to get delivered of it. Joseph forgave all those people and never held bitterness toward them. You're going to forgive them tonight. Joseph forgave himself for being a fool when he was young and aggravating his brothers and provoking them. You know what he did? He wept when he was had a reunion with his brothers. He wept. They treated him like trash and he forgave them. You've had people in your life that have treated you like trash. You're going to forgive them right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I forgive these people that have hurt me. I see Joseph's life. I see he made the choices I wish I had made. I see the choices. Come out, devil. I see the choices. I see the choices he made that I should have made, but I can still make. Come out, Spirit. I can still make these choices now, and I will. I'll repent of it. I'll repent of it right now. I'm going to forgive that employer that fired me or gave a promotion to somebody who was an idiot. I'm going to forgive them right now in the name of Jesus. I'm going to forgive my mother and my dad for favoring another brother or sister over me. I'm going to forgive them right now in the name of Jesus. Come on. I'm going to forgive them in the name of Jesus. Right this second. Right now. I'm going to forgive them. I'm going to release this ought in my soul. I'm going to let it go just like Joseph did. Just like Joseph. If somebody made up a big lie about me and hurt me and stabbed me in the back, just like Potiphar's wife, Joseph forgave her. I can do it because I got the Holy Ghost, the Spirit of the living God. Come out, Satan. I can do it. I can repent right now. And I will repent right now. I will repent. You're a Christian know-it-all. You're arrogant. You think you got everything going. If you take a look at your life, you'll see that you are not the genius you think you are. Just repent of it, and the Holy Spirit will turn the whole thing around, 100%. Let me tell you something. If he can take a kid from a dungeon to the prince of Egypt, he can handle anything the devil threw at you. Yes. Anything. Just repent of it. Come out, Satan. Just repent of it in the name of Jesus. Father, forgive me. Say it. Father, forgive me, Lord. See, dear Jesus, forgive me. I want to do what Joseph did. Come on, Lord, help me. I'm going to repent of it. I'm going to forgive my brothers for throwing me in a well like Joseph did. I'm going to forgive Potiphar's wife for stabbing me in the back and making up stories about me. That's what they did, Lord. They made up stories about me when I wasn't around, and I took an offense at it. I repent of it right now. I repent of it right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Come on. Just repent of it quickly. The Holy Ghost starting to move. Just repent of it quickly. The Spirit of God is here. And He has a destiny for you. Be patient and establish your heart. Come on. Be patient and establish yourself. Come on, just repent of it quickly. Come on now. Every lie, every offense, come out in the name of Jesus Christ. Every offense and every lie, come out right now in the name of Jesus. Come on out. Come on out. Come on. Come on out right now. Come out there, devil. Come out right now. Come out in Jesus' mighty name. Spirit, I command you to come out. Spirit of offense. You got a lust spirit like Potiphar's wife. All she thought about was lust. It ruined her life. It destroyed her. Come out, you ugly spirit of lust. Lust for food. Lust for sex. Lust and arrogance and pride and greed. Come out in the name of Jesus. Come out in the name of Jesus Christ. Come out. Come on out right now. Come on out right now.
Get up above that guy.
Oh, come on out right now. Get out of there. Just repent of it. Jesus, forgive me. Come on, say it. Come on now. Quickly. Quickly. The Spirit of God starting to move. Quickly. Quickly. Father God, I feel like somebody threw me in the dungeon. And I repent of it right now in the name of Jesus. I repent of it right now in the name of Jesus. I failed my test, Lord. I took an offense and I got angry. I lost my temper. My wife left me. My wife went back to her old boyfriend. My husband went back to his ex-wife. My heart fell out of my soul. My heart fell out of my soul. I'm going to repent of it tonight. I'm going to forgive her boyfriend, his girlfriend. I'm going to forgive both of them. And I'm going to repent of it right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, I'm going to repent of it right now. Come on in the name of Jesus Christ. Come on. Had Joseph sat around listening to demons, he'd have died in the dungeon. You're going to repent of listening to demons tonight. You're going to repent of listening to demons tonight. You're going to repent of it. You're going to stop living like a carnal Christian. Carnal entertainment, carnal TV shows. Carnal, 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 carnal. Satan, I bind your power. Come out! We're going to stop failing your tests. Come out in Jesus' mighty name. Satan, I bind your power. Come out in the name of the Lord. You've had a physical trial of sickness. You've been sick. It's wearing you out. It's wearing you out. Come down to the front. You've been sick and it's wearing you out. Come down to the front. Come on. Come down to the front.
Hey, can you go get Peter?
He went out. Come on. You got a sickness, something grinding you down. You got an emotional pain, something grinding you down. Come on. Come on, we're going to pray for you so you can be healed. We're going to pray for you so you can be healed. Hey, what's wrong with you, honey? What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? Come here, sweetie. Come on up. Come up here. Come on, sweetie. Come on, something grinding you down. Come on now. What is it? What's grinding you down? Come on, just repent of it. You failed your test, but you're going to reboot right now. You'll reboot right now. Come on, you failed your test. You're going to reboot. Come up here, sweetheart. Come on now. Hurry. Just repent of it. Bring her up here. Just repent of it. Just repent of it. Come on. I want to be like Joseph. I want to pass my test. I want to fulfill my destiny. My destiny's calling me. My destiny's calling me now. Come on. Come on, how you doing? How you been?
I was wondering if you could pray for me.
Are you listening to demons?
I might be.
Okay. Tell the Lord you're sorry. Close your eyes and tell him you're sorry. Dear Jesus. Dear Jesus, I repent of listening to demons. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me, Lord. I'm so sorry. God, have mercy on me. God, have mercy on my soul, Lord. Hey. Come on, did you repent?
Yeah.
Say it. You gotta say it out loud. I got demons in the brain. Come on, sweetie. Come on now, just repent of it. Just confess it. Lord, I failed my test. I failed it. I failed it. I want mercy. I want to reboot. You will get mercy. You will get mercy from God. If you repent of it, if you confess it, you will get mercy from God. The Bible guarantees it. Come on. Just repent of it. Come out. Satan. Satan, come out. Just repent of it. If you need prayer, come down here to the front quickly. Move quickly. Just repent of it. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just.
What is it? I got discouraged from reading the word, from getting on my knees and praying.
You got what?
Discouraged? I got discouraged.
From what?
I'm broken.
From what?
I committed adultery in my marriage. My wife forgave me, but I'm still carrying that, bro.
Okay, now listen. You're grieving the Holy Spirit because you already asked him to forgive you, didn't you?
Yeah.
Okay, he did. So he has no problem with you. But you got a problem with yourself, which hurts him. You're hurting him.
I have to forgive. I have to let it go, release it, right?
Yeah, you're holding this against yourself. Right?
Right.
God doesn't hold it against you. You're just doing it.
I need
to repent of that. That's the same sin if you held the same grudge against that woman.
Right. Oh, okay, sir.
What if you held a grudge against her? Oh, she cheated on her husband. I don't like her. I hate her. She's a sinner. That would be a terrible sin, wouldn't it?
Yes.
Well, you're doing it yourself. There's no sin anymore. You didn't do it.
The Lord forgive me, right?
Well, the Bible says if God forgives you, it's gone.
Gone.
You didn't do it.
Amen.
That's what it says.
Yeah, no,
it's
not
there.
I hear you.
You're not adulterer.
No.
You were, but you're not now.
Was.
It's gone.
Amen. I probably just need the strength too, brother, to move forward.
You speak in tongues?
Do I what?
You speak in tongues?
Not yet.
You don't? Okay. Now let's go ahead and pray. Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus Christ.
Please forgive me.
Please forgive me.
Please forgive me.
Forgive me, Father God.
Valerie.
Father God.
Please forgive me, Lord.
Forgive me, Father God. Please forgive me, Lord.
Please forgive me, Lord.
For
holding a grudge against myself. For hating myself.
For hating myself.
I'm so sorry.
For everything else, Father God.
I'm so sorry.
So sorry, God.
I repent of it.
I repent of it.
By holding this sin on myself, I'm calling you a liar.
Because
you forgave me.
Because you forgave me.
Tell me. Lord Jesus, I'm so sorry. So sorry.
I'm sorry, Father.
And I repent of adultery.
I repent of adultery.
I repent of pornography.
I repent of pornography.
I repent of lust.
I repent of lust.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, you've been forgiven.
Hallelujah.
Put your hand here. And take a big breath. Big breath. Take a big breath. Breathe out of your mouth. Breathe. Spirit of lust. You heard him repent. Now come out now. There he comes. Go. There he is. Come on out. Come on out, buddy. Come out. Come out. Get out of my body right now. Go. Go in Jesus' name. Go. Come on out.
Come out! Come out! Go! Go! Come out! Come out! Come out here! Lust for food, come out! Lust for sex, come out! Self-hatred! Injustice! Guilt and shame, come out right now! Come on out! Come on out! Go now! I said go now! Go now! Go now! Get out of that body right now, hurry up! Get out of the body right now. Come out of there. Go. Come on out. Come out. Guilt and shame. Go. Come on out. Guilt and shame. Go. Go now. Lust. Come out. Food demon. Come out. Food. Come out. Come on, just repent of it. Just confess it. Confess it. Spirit, I bind your power. I have authority over you. I command you to come out. Come out of me. There they come. Go. There they come. Get out in Jesus' holy name. Get out of there. Come out of that body. Go now. Go now. Come out of here. Quickly. Come out of my groin. Come out of my dreams. There he is. Come out of my dreams. Go now. Come out. Come out of my dreams. Get out of there. I want all this ugliness out of me. All this evil. I am a child of God, not a demon carrier. Come out of there. Come on out. Satan, come out. Who needs to be healed? Come on up here quickly. Who needs to be healed? Who needs to be healed? Come up here quickly. Follow her.
She'd repent of some sins. And she'd repent for doubting.
Oh, I repent of doubting right now. Come on out. Spirit of doubt. Come out of there. Come on out. Come on out. There it is. There he is. He's right there. Come out. Come on out. Unbelief. Doubt. Unbelief. And fear. Fear. Come out. Come on out. Fear. Come on out. Fear. 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 Come on, Smitty. Come on out. Fear. Hold that. Come on out right now. Go. Come out right now. Here it comes. Come out of her body. Demon of fear. Stop shaking her. Come out. Come out. You filthy devil. Stop shaking her. I said, come out of that body. There he comes. Here he comes. Here he comes. Go. Stop shaking her. Stop shaking her.
Which one?
Come out! Demon of fear, come out of that body. Parkinson's. Dementia, come out. Hate, hate and anger, come out of that body.
Get out!
Hate and anger, I said, come out. Come out of there. Right now! Evil, come out! Come out of there! You man hater! You man here, come out now! Come out right now! Come out right now! Come out! Come out! Come out! Come out of that body! Go out of that body right now! Come out now! Quickly! Come out now! Get out of that body, I said! Come out now! Come out of her throat! Come out! You man hater! You man hater! Come out, you man hater! Come out, you man hater! Get out of that body right now. She does not hate people. She does not hate herself. Get out of that body right now. Go. Come out. Go. Go now. Come on out. Come out of there. Come out of her throat. Get out of her out of there now. Go now. Go right now.
Come out.
Go right now.
Come out.
Hurry up. Hurry up.
Come out.
Hurry up. Come on. Quick. 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 Quick.
Let it go.
Quick.
Let it go.
Quick. Come on out right now. Quick.
Let it go.
Quick. Hatred. Hatred.
Come out.
Come out. Come out. Go. Come on. Just confess it. Hey, just confess it. Just admit it. You got to confess it to get healed. You cannot get healed if you do not confess. Out loud. Out loud. I'll help you. Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, I'm a know-it-all. I'm a know-it-all. I know everything. I'm a spiritual genius. I confess it. I'm a know-it-all. Just repent of that insanity. You don't know it all. You know very little. You actually know very little. Just repent of it. Come on. Lord, I'm too afraid to come up for prayer. I got a coward demon. You got a coward demon. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and love and a sound mind. The Greek word for fear is dilea. It means cowardice. God has not given us a spirit of cowardice. Come on, step out and repent of it. Step out. Do it now. Do it now. Step out. You are not a coward. You are not a coward. You are not a coward. Repent of it. Just repent of it. Just repent of it. You are not a coward. Repent. Repent. Change. Become a different person. Change. You are not where you need to be spiritually. Change. Now. Change now. Thus saith the Lord. If thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God and do what is right and keep his commandments and follow his precepts, thus saith the Lord, I will put none of these diseases upon you. I put on the Egyptians, for I am Yahweh Rapha. I am the eternal God who heals you. Come up and get healed tonight. Come forward and get healed. Come forward and get healed. Yahweh Rapha, the Son of God, is waiting for you. Come on. That problem with your bones, your joints, that's caused by bitterness. Your bones and your joints, that's caused by bitterness. It's caused by emotional pain. Emotional pain. If you got joint problems, that girl right there needs help praying. The one right there, black. If you got joint problems, that's a spirit that got into your body through taking offenses, anger, and bitterness.
Out, Jesus.
Keep coughing. Don't stop. Keep going. Go.
You had
bitterness in your soul, and now your back is out. Your shoulders are out. Your feet hurt. You've lost it. You've lost it. Come on. Just repent of it. You can leave here tonight well. Come on, just repent. Let your tears go. Let your tears go. Quickly. Let your tears go. Come on. Hurry up. Come out. Come out. Come out. Come out. Fight harder. Come on, sweetheart. Fight harder. Fight harder. Every ugly man. Come on, ladies. Did you used to sleep around a lot? You were in adultery? When you slept with all them guys, you picked up demons. You picked up demons when you were sleeping with all them guys. You're an adulterer. You're an adulteress. Come on, repent of it. Come down here quickly. Quickly. You two, put your hand on your body. One on your stomach, one on your chest. Command the devil to come out. Put your hand on your head. Command the demon to come out. Command him to go. Go! I command you to come out. Right now, I said. Go now! Get out of my head! You coward! You coward, spirit! Go now! Come out now! Just forgive them. Come on, repent of it. Let's go. Just repent. Just confess it. Just repent. Come on. Repent. Repent. Confess. Come on. Satan, I bind your power. Satan, I command you. I command you to listen. I've been listening to you for years. I can't take it anymore. Now you listen to me. I command you, Satan. Get out of my body right now. Thus saith the Lord. Behold, I give you power to tread on scorpions and serpents and over all the power of the enemy. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Come on. Thus saith the Lord. These signs shall follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out demons. In my name they shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Come on. Repent of your sin. Let's do it. Don't sit around like you know something. You're collating this thing. Oh, let me figure it out. Stop it. Just repent of it. Stop. Just repent. Stop it. Demon of lust, come up. Demon of fear, I command you. Manifest, come up. Come up. Spirit of cowardice, you coward spirit, come up. You coward spirit, come up. Right now. Come up. Come up. Hurry. Come on, you need prayer for healing tonight. Come up here. Hurry up. You got to forgive somebody. Come on, let's go. Forgive them. Say it. You say, well, they were at fault. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if they were at fault. You got to forgive them. You were at fault and God forgave you. Freely you have received. Freely give. You got to repent. You got to forgive. Doesn't matter if they're at fault. Doesn't matter who's at fault. Come on, repent. Let's go. Let's go. God freely forgave you supernaturally and miraculously. Now you freely got it. So now you freely give it. Freely give it right now. I command you lust demons. I command transgender demons. Homosexuality. I bind your power. I bind your filthy power here tonight. You pervert. You pedophile. You pedophile. You adulterer. You adulteress. I bind your power, you filthy spirit. I bind your power, you filthy spirit. Repent of it. Some of you have somebody in your family who's really sick. They're really sick. And the devil told you, hey, you're not as sick as they are, so you must be okay. That's a lie. You're sick too. You're not listening. You're sick too. It's a trick. The devil gets you to look at the family member who's really sick, and you're sick, and then he tells you, you're okay. Look, you're better than them. You look better than them. The truth of the matter is, you're sick. You're sick. Had you not been sick, the other people wouldn't have been sick.
We need help.
Sweetheart, what's wrong?
She's just been harming herself, and so when he tries to restrain her,
Now what about you?
I'm so sore and tired and hurting.
Now, listen. You're the mother, right?
Right.
And you love her.
Yeah.
Okay, now you fall into a trap. You fell into a trap. Okay. And it's going to kill you. The devil takes mother's love.
That's where I got kicked. Sorry.
The devil takes mother's love and then gets her to love too much.
Yeah.
So they carry burdens. And that's a sin. So when they start carrying burdens, then demons start getting in their body and their joints start hurting, their stomach hurts, their organs hurt, their feet hurt, everything starts hurting.
I do have autoimmune disease, so.
Okay, now autoimmune disease is caused by the soul. Emotional pain in the soul transfers to the body and the body turns on itself. Okay, now tonight you're going to repent. Correct?
I can't see either.
That's good. Close your eyes since you can't see. What's your name again?
Tracy.
Tracy, yeah. My daughter's name is Tracy. Thank you, Jesus. Father, look at Tracy down here tonight. She is in big trouble. If her daughter was perfectly healed tonight, she would still be in big trouble. Because she violated your word. And the devil took advantage of her. She loves. She's a loving person. And the devil taught her to take on burdens. And now her body has turned on her. She has an autoimmune disease. It's caused by wounds in the soul. And she's going to repent of it tonight. The Bible says we are to cast all our care upon him. For he cares for us. And she hasn't done that. She's been carrying the burden on herself. It's the first thing she said to me when she came up for prayer. My daughter really needs help. What she was really saying was, my daughter has worn me almost to the grave. That's what she was really saying. And she's going to repent of it right now. You're going to repent of it right this second. Dear Jesus, I'm so sorry for what I've done. I've taken in wounds in my soul. The devil sent me a spirit of infirmity. He's right in there. And he's turning my body against me. He's turning my body against me. My body that was my friend when I was young is now my enemy. And I release my daughter. And I repent of worrying about her, fretting over her, bending over backwards to help her, wearing myself out to help her. I repent of it right now in the name of Jesus. And I release her now. I release her now in the name of Jesus. Take a big breath and blow. Well, come out now. Don't keep blowing. Come out. Come out right now. Come out. Sydney, come out of there. Sydney, come out right now. Come out of my body right now. Let it go. I let it go right now. All these other wounds, all these people betrayed me. I have lived a life like Joseph. Everybody stabbed me in the back. All my friends turned on me. I release them now. I'm going to let them go right now in the name of Jesus. I'm going to let Sydney go right now. Go now. Amen. Release her to you. Come on. Every spirit of insanity that transferred from my daughter to me, every spirit that got in my body that tells me to use food as a comfort from this miserable life, my daughter has worn me completely out. And I'm repenting of it tonight. I'm going to let her go. No, you're going to release them tonight. No, that not intellectually giving her like you did last time because you just took her right back. That's intellectual. Come on. Do you speak in tongues?
No.
Are you born again?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Okay. Take a big breath now. Take a big breath. So sorry, Lord, I hurt you. So sorry I hurt you. Come on, Lord. Help me, dear Lord. I want the spirit of fear out of me. Fear for my daughter's future. Come out right now. Fear for my daughter's future. Come out now. Come on out of there. Come up. Come up. Fear of Sydney. Come up. What's she going to do after we're dead? Fear of her future. Come out. Worry. Worry. Come out of me right now. I repent of it. Worry. Come out of my joints. I command this autoimmune spirit to come out of my body right now. You spirit of infirmity. Come out of me. Autoimmune disease. Come out of my joints. Come out of my joints right now. Come out. Come out, I said. Come out. Food demon. Eating. Overeating. Using food as a comfort. Come out of me right now, I said. Come out of me, you rotten devil. This isn't funny. I hate your guts. Come out of my body. Come on, sweetheart. Just get mad. Come on. The devil's trying to take your whole family apart. He's trying to pull you apart like pulling legs off a spider. Just plucking them off. Sydney's gone now. Now he's come for you. This is what you're going to do? The demons got Sydney. Now they're coming for you. Really? This is how it ends? I say no. God, forgive me. God, forgive me, Lord. I want this ugly autoimmune disease and these soul wounds and taking in pain and carrying burdens out of me right now in the name of Jesus. Come out of me in the name of Jesus. Go. Come out right now. Come on out. Come out. Come out of there.
Please don't worry. Come out.
Okay, now that's good. We already know that. Now talk to that spirit right there and tell him to come out. Tell him to come out. Talk right to him. Tell him. Tell him to come out. Come on, if we don't get him out of here, you're going to die of an autoimmune disease. Okay, that's not a pretty sight. Okay, that's an ugly way to go, ma'am. No offense. Now that thing needs to come out of there. This thing's not funny. That thing's trying to kill you. These demons took your daughter. She's losing her mind. Spirits are real, man. These things are real. And you've got an autoimmune disease, and this thing's going to get ugly on you. And God is not, that is not God's will. He likes you. He wants to heal you. He loves you. We need to get you on board here. We need to get you on board here. What are you thinking about? What do you think about?
He's healed me several times already.
What do you mean he's healed you several times?
I've had
you
said breast you had cancer. He healed me of that.
But you said you had autoimmune disease.
I had autoimmune disease. I also had a stroke and then found a brain tumor. And they operated on me after I was prayed over and the brain tumor was gone. So.
Okay, ma'am, listen to me. You know what a pinball machine is? Have you ever seen an old pinball machine years ago when I was in the bars drinking, you blow a couple bucks? The demons just simply go from one sickness to another in you. God heals that one, they go to that one. God heals that one, then they go to that one. That's because they're not coming out. You don't see that? You just rattled off four illnesses.
Yeah, I know, but they...
How could somebody have four...
miraculously healed them.
I know the illness was healed, but the spirit didn't come out.
Okay.
Are you following me? The pinball, the ball doesn't come out. Boing, bang, boom, 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 boom. The ball's in the machine.
Okay.
Does that make sense? Can you explain it better? I don't think she's listening to me.
That's a great analogy right there.
You need to release Sydney.
Well, that's what I was doing.
Hey, did you understand what I told her?
Yeah.
You did?
So you got an autoimmune disease too.
Oh, as far as the... letting go of the overburden on herself?
Well, no, she's in much worse shape than I thought. She just told me she had four different illnesses, right?
Yeah, she said
she had four of them. God healed three of them. The demons simply go to the next illness after the other one's healed. You don't see that?
I didn't really quite see it that way, I guess, but
okay. If God heals you of that, the demons go, okay, you're healed there. Now we'll give you that. So then they gave her breast cancer, then they gave her this, then now they've got it autoimmune. Does that make sense? They're just simply pinballing around in a body. As soon as she gets healed, she gets another illness. Correct?
That's what
I mean, if I'm hearing this correct.
There's always been something for 20, 30
There's always been something, exactly, because they haven't been removed. We got to get them things out of there. She's been collecting these. She's what?
I got a headache.
Now they're giving her a headache while I'm talking to her. Hey, ma'am, I'm fighting for your life right now harder than you are.
I just can't find it to get rid of it. Does that make?
That's because you're not listening to me.
I am listening.
Okay, you got to speak directly to that horrible spirit that's giving you them illnesses. Do you understand what I'm saying? That's him right there. You got to get mad at him.
Go away.
Come on. Now this lady here is struggling to get healed because she giggles and she's insecure. Hey, that's not gonna work. See, if you don't know about spiritual warfare, YouTubers. Then you listen to somebody who does know about it. You don't tell them what to do and how to do it. What are you, nuts? Are you cracked up? If you knew what you were doing, you'd have already been healed. What do you need to go somewhere for if you know how to do it? Total insanity. Hey, stop listening to demons and just simply listen to the word of God. The demons get in the body. They must come out of the body. It's that simple. This isn't rocket science. A spirit gets in your body. You get sick. A spirit gets in your brain. You get a mental illness. The demon is removed. You get well. This isn't rocket science. It's the God's word, and it's simply done by faith. Am I right, lady? You do it by faith. I'll lead you through it. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I just heard Brother Mike ranting and raving on the YouTube. And he's right. I command this spirit. The Bible says those who believe will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. I'm going to lay hands on my body right now in the name of Jesus. I command this mental illness demon to come out of me. I command the spirit of my brain to come out of me. Get out of my head. Get out of my head, I said. Now. Come on now. I command this ugly spirit to get out of my body. Put your hands on your body, YouTuber. What you need, honey?
I'm just tired. What's of happening? Dialysis and intersex boot infirmity. I got blood clot in my jugular, dialysis, eye surgeries. It's always something.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, let's go back in time for a second here. When did that start?
14.
You're 14. Okay.
Yeah. And then, I feel that my husband poisoned me. Huh? I can feel my husband poisoned me. It caused a lot of health problems.
Hold on. Now you were 14. You were married then?
No, 2014.
Oh, no. 2014. Before that, were you healthy?
Yeah.
Never
been in the hospital overnight or anything.
Okay. And then, are you still married?
No, he abandoned me. And he got remarried 2 weeks
okay.
ago.
But he's been now, what religion was he?
Huh?
What religion was he?
Well, we both believe in apostolic, like baptism in Jesus' name, Holy Spirit. We're both.
And he backslid?
I think he did, but I don't know. I don't have proof of it. But he was just doing a lot of
behavior.
He's abusive towards me.
Physically or verbally?
Well, he was verbally abusive.
What's his name?
His name is Troy.
Tony?
Troy.
Troy. Okay. Yeah. Now, here's what happens. Whenever you're in a bad marriage, the demons from the other spouse transfer in here. And sometimes they can put a curse on you. Which kind of sounds like something happened with Troy in 2014. I'm guessing. Okay, I don't know your background. Okay. Now, just close your eyes there. Take a big breath. Now, just try to relax. Just try to relax. Totally relax. Good. That's good. Excellent. Relax. Breathe. Breathe. Father, I want to ask you tonight if you would go hunt for Tony.
Troy.
I want you to go find Troy tonight. And I want you to put your hands on him. And I want you to tell him that you love him and that he doesn't ever have to hurt anybody ever again. You understand him? You love him? Whoa. You love, whoa. You love him? Whoa. You love him? Thank you. You love him and he doesn't ever have to hurt anybody again. And I want you to tell him that his wife and brother Mike have forgiven him for what he did. In 2014, her husband abandoned her. And she is going to forgive him. Come on, let your tears go, honey. You'll get healed right there. Father God, what do you need? What happened?
There's a spirit that runs through my family that the girls, if they get married, they can't stay married. Started from my generation.
So they all get divorced.
Now my nieces, yeah. And if I get, if God brings a man of God to me, mm-hmm. then they don't stay. Something happens and they leave.
Now I want to ask you a couple of questions here. Just relax. Try to relax. What's your name?
Stephanie.
All right, Stephanie. Beautiful. Close your eyes there for a second. Now, when you was in preschool, before kindergarten, did somebody hurt you?
No.
How about in grade school? Were you bullied?
Oh.
Somebody hurt you real bad?
I took a girl's boyfriend in high school. It seemed like it started from there. I was about 16 or 17.
You were about 16?
16, 17.
And is that when you lost your virginity? With that boyfriend?
Not with that boyfriend.
Before him?
It was not that boyfriend that I lost it with.
What, did you lose it before him?
Before
that guy?
Yeah.
What age was that?
16, 17.
Now, what was his name? What's his first
John.
Name? John, okay. What religion was John?
Heathen.
All right. Now, close your eyes there and take a big breath. Big breath there. Father God, you see this beautiful woman right here? She has got a deep agitation in her soul. And she's very tense. And this is reflected in her personality. She has a very intense personality. And it runs men off. And it's caused by this spirit husband that got in there during adultery when she was in her teens. And her family curse let him in. She has a very tense sense about her personality that runs people off. That ugly spirit of anxiety manifests in tension. People see her, other women see it too. They don't like it either. Church people don't like it either. She's had many relationships break because this thing manifests all the time. It just manifested 60 seconds ago when I was talking to her. It's been doing it for decades. Take a big breath and breathe out of your mouth. You filthy spirit from her teenage years, you used her body for perversion. You used her to pick up a spirit husband who broke all of her relationships off. He broke them all off. You're hiding in there. There he is. You're hiding in there. Come on, that body right now. Come out of her throat. Stop jumping around in there. Come out right now. That's him jumping. Come on out. And the devil knew that she could never get married because she's already married to a demon spirit husband. So they kept sending her suitors, and then they all abandoned her. They came in initially looking good and friendly and loving, and then bang, they dumped her. And when they left, they took a little piece of her heart out. One ugly man after the other took the soul and put these scars in her soul. And now she's wounded. Wounded. Lord Jesus, forgive me. Forgive me for trying to develop relationships and not seeing I had a spirit husband that breaks every relationship off. They're doomed from the start. And I let him in when I lived in adultery as a teenager. He got in, and I want him out. He's blocking the husband that you have for me. I'm going to die an old maid if I don't get a divorce from this monster. Oh, God. I'm not going to die an old maid, you filthy spirit. I command you in the name of Jesus. I command you, you rotten devil. Come out of me right now. Spirit husband, you've stolen every relationship, every man. All you do is waste my time, my money, my life, my years, all wasted. Come out. Come out.
Come out
of my body. Come out, you spirit of adultery. Come out. Come out. Adulterer. Every ugly man, come out of me. Come out in Jesus' holy name. Get out of there.
Come out.
Come out of there right now.
Come out.
Come out of my body.
Come out of my body.
Jesus' mighty name. Come out of there.
Come out.
Hurry up. Hurry up.
Come out.
Come out.
Come out.
Come on. Let your tears go. Come on. Let your tears go.
Come out.
One wasted marriage, one wasted relationship after the other. Literally. Literally, they're everywhere. For years this went on. For years I lost everyone. Even the women are turning on me. In the name of Jesus. Tension and fear. Tension and fear. Come out. Any spirit transferred into me during a prophetic meeting, a prayer tunnel, a fire tunnel, anything, I command you, Kundalini. I bind your power. Come out.
Come out.
Come out of there.
Come out.
Go now in Jesus' mighty name. Come out of me right there.
Come out.
Come on, honey. Let your tears go. Come on. Every year wasted.
Every year
is gone. Go. All the waste. All the money gone. They used me. They used me. Then they abused me. They took from me. They stole from me. Come out in the name of Jesus. Get out of there. I command every church demon by the power of the Holy Ghost. Every spirit from church, come out of my body.
Come out of my body. Come out of my body. Come out of my body.
Get out.
Get out.
Every spirit from every man I slept with, every one of them, every transfer spirit, get out of there. Right now. They told me they loved me until they slept with me. Then they were gone. It was a demon setting me up. The demon set me up. It was a trick. It was a trick. I got set up. Father, forgive me. I didn't see it. I'm so sorry. Father, forgive me. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Get out of that body right now.
Come out.
Come out in the name of Jesus Christ. Come on out. I claim back every wasted year. It's been decades. Decades, oh God, have mercy on me. Mercy, Lord. Decades. Gone. Oh God. Oh God. I never saw it. This ugly demon, the spirit husband, stole everything from me. Every man, every ministry, The church people turn on me. Friends turn on me. Father, I know what Joseph felt like. But tonight, this monster comes out. Go let your tears go, honey. Come on. Come on. Get out of that body. Come out quicker. Faster. Come out. Every ugly man goes. Every one of them. I command my ex-husband to come out of me.
Go.
Get out of that body. You filthy spirit husband. Come out of me right now. You've stolen the last relationship. Get out of my body right now. Come out of my stomach. Come out of my womb. Come out of my vagina. Come on, my kidneys. Come on, my liver. Come on now.
Come out.
Go in Jesus' holy name.
Go in Jesus' name.
Right now, I said.
Go. Get out. Go in Jesus' name.
Atta girl. Get him.
Go.
Go get him, sweetheart. YouTube, I'll be back next Friday with another unusual Bible study. Go to the website right now because you will be attacked within 48 hours of this service. Click the teaching button. Go to the teaching button. Hit the button. How Satan controls the mind. Read that short article. Read the short article. Satan's counterattack. You will get hit within 48 hours of this service. You must be ready for it. You must stand and steady yourself. HardcoreChristianity.com. Next Friday, teaching here at the Arizona Deliverance Center. Our Healing House manager has arrived, and we will be able to take more people to stay at our residential facility. If you'd like to come for a 2 or 3 day visit, contact me, Mike@HardcoreChristianity.com. The devil got routed tonight. Routed. He'll get it next week too. Don't forget Thursday night, the healing room with Brother Rick. Powerful deliverances and healings. Thursday night, mental illness healing class, 7 p.m. here at the Deliverance Center. I'll see you next time.